different flavor music. There's a reason.
Yes, I understand that every life must end.
Hey, traveling man, I think you just text me. I'll holler at you here in a minute, brother.
As we settle down,
making a video.
Someday we must go.
Still in Chicago.
Oh, I'm a lucky man to count on both hands.
There's a reason I'm playing this song. It's why I drive trucks.
Some folks just have one.
Not because of this song, but because of who's singing it and who liked it.
Stay with me.
My mom was the one that got me out here on the road. When I was a kid, we moved everywhere. And she made it fun every time we moved. I mean, we go flying down the interstate in the old cars we was in. No, they wasn't. They're old now, but they wasn't old then. They was newer cars, but just made it fun. We ran with truck drivers and we get running at night time. There'd be a truck passes, and my mom would speed up and keep with them and run with them. And boy, that just made my day, man. I couldn't believe that. I'd hear them tires. I'd roll my window down so I could hear them tires going woo 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 woo. And man, that just made me feel so good. Then we'd stop at a truck stop, go get something to eat. Back then, it was mostly all cab overs. I mean, there was some conventionals, but most of the trucks was... Boy, my damn lips started quivering. It made me feel weird. But anyway, there wasn't a whole lot of conventional trucks back then. It was all cab overs, not all, but mostly. And when you go out there and you stand in front of them great big cab overs, man, you look up at that and you're 9, 10, 11 years old and you're staring up at that thing and you see that windshield way up there and you're like, oh my God, look at that. How does somebody drive that? How does that thing go down the road as fast as we was going a minute ago? I don't understand that. And then the guy gets out and looks at you and says, how you doing, buddy? And just talks to you and makes you feel good and just go on in and eat. Back then it was 76 truck stops, White House truck stops. There wasn't no pilots, TAs and all that. I can't even remember because the TA wasn't even thought of back then, but that's one of the reasons it got me into trucking right there is my mom. I can say without a doubt, my mom is the reason I'm a truck driver. It ain't because my uncle taught me how to drive a truck. It's because my mom, when I was growing up, we moved a lot, traveled up and down the highways, and she made it so fun for us to travel up and down the highway that it gave me a bug that I just couldn't get rid of. And I'm still doing it today. I call her, try to call her every day. And she'll say, where you at today, son? And I tell her. And we got kind of a funny relationship. We're a little bit hard on each other, but she always tells me, be careful, watch what you're doing, be safe. And watch what you're doing. When she says be safe, she's saying make smart decisions. Don't be stupid. Because all it takes is one stupid decision. And you're no longer with us. You're a memory. You're something that people talk about. Says, yeah, he was a good guy, but he went around this curve or did this or did that and he died. You know, don't be that. Be that guy that can come home every weekend and be with your family. You know, it don't matter if you pass that truck in front of you. It don't matter if you pass that car in front of you. If that car in front of you locked the brakes up or whatever and pissed you off, okay. Don't worry about it. Go on. It ain't going to change your life none. It ain't going to make your life any better, any worse, unless you make it any better or any worse. You can do something stupid and make it turn out real worse. So just know that you're in your workplace and the people around you aren't in your workplace. They're on their trip and they think they own the road. So let them think that and just let them go, man. You can't change the world. Just, oh my God, listen to that. Listen to that.
For love's the greatest healer to be found.
It's my mommy's favorite song in the world.
So leave me if you need to.
I love some Willie. Somebody bait you into doing something stupid. Somebody cut you off. Man, they're not in their workplace. You're in your workplace. And they'll tell you when you go into your job, say you go into work in a factory, and they say, hey, here's the hazards, and here's what you got to watch out for. You need to avoid this. So what you're doing truck driving, you have to do that to yourself, because they don't do that out here. They don't tell you the hazards. They tell you the hazards, but they don't tell you the real hazards. Are the pissed off people going to work that think you're in their way because you're out here too? Every morning when they go to work, there's trucks out there because trucks run 24/7. They don't never stop. So, sorry, I got to put the phone down. So when these same people come out every morning to go to work and they see a truck in their way, they see the same truck that was there yesterday. Even though it's a different guy driving a different truck, it doesn't matter. It's the same motherfucker that was in their way yesterday, and they're pissed off that you're in their way. So you need to move. Don't work like that. But that don't mean you can retaliate, because what you're driving can kill people. So use patience. They don't understand that you don't follow them to work, and then once they're working, you walk out there and say, hey, get the fuck out of my way. You're in my goddamn way. Move out of the fucking way. Because that's how they feel. Whenever you're in their way, supposed way, it ain't like that. Be calm. Be cool. Make a smart decision. I ain't saying move over and let the dumbass pass. But don't do nothing stupid that's going to maybe put you in prison for the rest of your life. Or maybe cause you to kill somebody that'll put you in prison for the rest of your life. You got a big responsibility, man. You got to use it wisely. You can't just jump out there and do shit. You can't whip that wheel and do this and do that, because it don't always turn out right. So, just be smart, man. Travel man, I see you're texting me. I'm going to text you back here in just a minute. You called me just like 2 minutes ago. Or did you call or text? You might have called. I don't know. I was on the phone still with my wife. Sorry, because when my kid calls, man, we talk for hours. So if I don't answer, I'm on the phone with my boy. That's the only time I won't answer is when I'm on the phone with my boy. Any other time, I'll answer. I don't care if I'm on the phone with my boss. If I get a phone call, I'm like, oh, hold on. Got another phone call. When my kid calls, he gets 100% of my attention. I don't answer the phone for nobody else. I don't care who it is. Not saying you're less important. Just, you understand. You guys, be smart. Don't act like these dumbasses out here on the road. Somebody pisses you off, don't try to retaliate, man. Because then you're no better than them. You ain't no better than them. Back off, let them go. You'd be mad at somebody else in another 2 miles, so it don't fucking matter. You can't wreck everybody. Now, on my last day at work, when I'm retiring and I know I'm parking the truck and ain't never gonna drive again, I'm telling you right now, don't get in my motherfucking way, because I will stick you in the motherfucking ditch hard. Guaranteed. Truck hard, truck safe. Make smart decisions.